Congrats on your new MPK Mini. Whether you have the iconic MPK Mini MK3, the versatile MPK Mini Plus, or the ultra-portable MPK Mini Play, this video will guide you through the installation and setup of its included software. First, go to profile.inmusicbrands.com, log into your InMusic profile, and register your MPK Mini. This will give you access to your included software. For help with creating an InMusic profile or registering a product to it, check out the short video walkthroughs linked below. The InMusic Software Center is the key to your MPK Mini's included software, so let's get it set up. Go to the product registrations page in your InMusic profile and open your MPK Mini's downloads menu. Under Software Downloads, open the entry for the InMusic Software Center and click the download link for your computer's operating system, either macOS or Windows. For now, keep your browser open and logged in to your InMusic profile. You'll need to access it again soon. On macOS, double-click the downloaded zip file, then double-click the InMusic Software Center application to open it. On Windows, just double-click the downloaded .exe file, and the InMusic Software Center will install and open automatically. To link the InMusic Software Center with your InMusic profile, click Let's Go and follow the prompts in your web browser. The setup wizard will tell you to plug in your MPK Mini, which is necessary for software authorization. Use your MPK Mini's included USB cable to connect it to one of your computer's USB ports. If you have an MPK Mini Play, set the power switch to USB and make sure the internal sounds button is deactivated. Once you're connected, click Redeem Software to register your software to your InMusic profile. The following screens are for selecting the plugin instruments, apps, and MPC sound packs that come bundled with your MPK Mini. Make your selections and hit Done. The installers for your software will automatically download after you finish the setup wizard. First, install your apps and plugin instruments by clicking Install in their entries and following the installation prompts. To install your MPC sound packs, click on the My Expansions tab and install them using the same method. The plugin instruments you just installed can be used either in MPC Beats, which we'll get to later, or as a standalone application. Just click Open next to one of them. In the Settings menu, make sure that your desired audio output is selected and that your MPK Mini is checked under Active MIDI Inputs. Using these instruments in standalone is great for experimenting and quickly fleshing out ideas without having to open a DAW. Speaking of DAWs, let's set up the one you just installed, MPC Beats. After opening MPC Beats, the MIDI setup wizard will ask you to connect your keyboard. Make sure your MPK Mini is connected before clicking Next. MPC Beats will automatically select your MPK Mini's MIDI map, and then you can select between a simple or advanced workspace. Let's keep it simple for now. Next, open the Preferences menu by pressing Command comma on macOS or Control comma on Windows. In the Audio Device tab, you can select your desired audio output and input devices, as well as adjust the sample rate and audio buffer size if you like. In the MIDI Sync tab, you'll see that MPC Beats recognizes your MPK Mini and has selected its default MIDI input modes. If you don't see your MPK Mini here, make sure the Enable MIDI Ports When Discovered option is turned on, then disconnect and reconnect your MPK Mini. Finally, click on the Plugins tab, click the checkbox next to the default VST folder, then click Rescan All, and your new plugin instruments will be loaded into MPC Beats. If you need a reference for the default VST file paths on macOS and Windows, I've put them down in the description. Let's wrap up with a quick demo of loading drum programs and plugin instruments in MPC Beats. Akai Pro's MPC Beats Academy videos are great for learning how to produce in MPC Beats, so we won't get into too much detail here. You can find the link to MPC Beats Academy down below. To find a drum program, open the media browser by pressing B on your keyboard. You can use the filters to narrow your search. Double-click on a drum program to load it into your project. Now, tapping the pads on your MPK Mini will now trigger the sounds in the program. By opening Track View, you can draw or record MIDI notes to get your beat started. To load a plugin instrument, click this little arrow in the track pane, select an unused track, click the plugin icon, open the plugin drop-down menu, and select your desired instrument. By pressing the explode icon, you can leaf through presets and adjust individual parameters. Now all that's left to do is build out your project and create something you're happy with. Be sure to check out the resources linked down in the description for more tutorials on using your MPK Mini and MPC Beats. To access the Akai Pro knowledge base and technical support team, visit akaipro.com/support. Thanks for tuning in. We'll catch you next time.